Depression in freezing point of aqueous solution 0.5 molal non-electrolyte solute is where Kf for water is given, which is 1.86 Kelvin per molal. The options are 0.52 Kelvin, next is 1.86 Kelvin, the next is 0.186 Kelvin, and the last is 0.93 Kelvin. So students, there's a formula to calculate depression in freezing point, which is represented as delta Tf, which is equals to I into Kf into molality. Since we are given with non-electrolyte solute, that means the value of I will be 1. The value of Kf is already given, which is 1.86, and the value of molality is already given, which is 0.5. We only need to multiply the given values, which is equals to 0.93 Kelvin. That means the correct answer for this question is option number 4. Moving to next question, which is 62. If 3 mole of liquid A, where PA0 is equals to 400 mmHg, and 5 mole of liquid B, where PB0 is equals to 300 mmHg, are mixed to form a ideal solution, then mole fraction of A in vapor is? The options are 1 upon 3, the next is 2 upon 3, the next is 4 upon 9, and the last is 5 upon 9. Students, in this question, we are given with two liquids, that is liquid A and liquid B. We are also given with the number of moles of A and B, also the vapor pressure of pure liquid A and that of pure liquid B. And now we have to calculate mole fraction of A in vapor state. So students, now I am calculating the mole fraction of A in vapor phase. And the formula for that is YA is equals to partial pressure of A upon total pressure. So the value of partial pressure of A will be calculated by multiplying the mole fraction of A, vapor pressure of A in pure state, and we can calculate total pressure by adding the partial pressure of A and partial pressure of B. So let's see, mole fraction of A, PA naught. Total pressure is equals to partial pressure of A plus partial pressure of B, which is given by mole fraction of A, PA naught, plus mole fraction of B multiplied by PB0, which is the pressure of B in pure state. Let's put the values. Mole fraction of A is equals to moles of A upon total moles, which is 3 plus 5, that is 8. PA0 is equals to 400 upon 3 upon 8 into 400 plus 5 upon 8, which is mole fraction of B multiplied by PB0, which is pressure of B in pure state, is equals to 300, which gives a total of 1200 divided by 1200 plus 1500, which is equals to 1200 upon 2700, which is equals to 4 upon 9. That means the correct answer for this question is option number 3. Let's read the question, students. Example of negative deviation solution is, the options are acetone plus aniline, the next is acetone plus ethanol, the next is acetone plus benzene, and the last is ethanol plus water. Students, as we all know that negative deviation arises when the intermolecular forces of attraction between solute and solvent is more than that exists between solute-solute molecules and solvent-solvent molecules. So let's start with the first option, which is acetone and aniline. So I'm drawing the structure of acetone and aniline, H, NHC6H5. Here H is delta positive, O is delta negative. So there exists hydrogen bonding. So student, it is clear that in this case, the intermolecular forces of attraction between solute and solvent is more than that is solute-solute and solvent-solvent. That means option number 1 will show negative deviation and the rest 3 options will show positive deviation. So the correct answer for this question is option number 1. Moving to next question, which is 64. Metallic solids in the following is, the options are NaCl, next is MgO, next is copper or rubber. Students, this is one of the easiest question and a very popular question as well, as it is very clear that copper is a metallic solid. That means the correct answer for this question is option number 3. Moving to question number 65. Contribution of an atom present at the corner of FCC unit cell is? The options are 1 upon 8, the next is 1 upon 3, the next is 1 upon 6, and the last is 1 upon 4. Students, as we all know that the atom present at the corner of FCC unit cell is shared between 8 adjacent unit cells. 4 unit cells in the same layer and 4 unit cells in the upper or lower layer. That means contribution of one atom will be 1 upon 8. So the correct answer for this question is option number 1. Moving to next question, which is 66.